In today's tutorial, I'm going to be teaching you about enumerations, or enum for short, in C++. Let's do this. So the topics we're going to be covering today is, first off, what is an enumeration? When should you use it? When to use an enumeration versus a string array? When should you use enumerations versus constant variables? How to create one, as well as how to use one. So first off, what is an enumeration anyways? An enumeration, or enum for short, is basically a user-defined data type that contains a list of named constants. In other words, enumerations allow you to create your own data type, and it contains a list of labeled constant values that are related to one another. So when should you use them? Well, you should use enumerations if you want to create your own data type, as well as grouping a list of related pieces of information under their own labels. And not only that, the values in the list cannot be changed, okay? That's a very key point to note. So first off, because enumerations are very similar to string arrays, why not use just a string array? And why use enumerations? Well, first off, let's look at the differences between the two. For enumerations, you cannot change the values once it's compiled, okay? And not only that, you are going to be the one who will make and define the data type. Whereas arrays, the values can be changed, and you have to use a predefined data type. And then, because enumerations, like I said before, are basically a list of constant values, okay? So why not use multiple constant variables? Well, one of the reasons why you want to use enumerations over constant variables is enumerations are good for storing a list of values that are related to one another. For instance, if you want to list seasons of the years, you know, then you would use an enumeration. However, you would use a constant if the value or values are unrelated to one another. For instance, like the value of pi, or for instance, Boltzmann's constant. If you have those two in a program, you want to create them as two separate constant variables instead of putting them together in a single enumeration because they're both unrelated to each other. So how do we create one? So to create an enumeration is very simple. First off, type in the word enum, which stands for enumeration in its shorthanded form, followed by the name of the enumeration and then a pair of curly brackets and a semicolon. And inside your curly brackets is where you would list your labeled values separated by commas in the form of a name. Now make sure you give a good name or give some time to think of a good name for your enumeration because that basically represents your data type name. So for instance, int represents integer. So if you give your name, for example, let's say we create a enumeration for the seasons, then you would call the enumeration season, and then the values inside of season would be spring, summer, fall, or winter. You can put them in any order, by the way. It's just that make sure you give it good names. Okay, so let's create an enumeration in Visual Studio. So as we learned in the PowerPoint earlier, that to create an enumeration, simply type in enum followed by the name of the enumeration. So let's create the enumeration that we had in the PowerPoint, which is season, followed by a pair of curly brackets and a semicolon. And inside the curly brackets, we would list out our values. In this case, because seasons, there are only four in a year, let's list them out as spring, summer, fall, and winter. Okay, so inside the main function, in order for us to use an enumeration, like actually putting it to good use instead of just defining it, let's create a simple, let's say, if-else statement. So before we do that, let's create a season variable. So season, this season, equals, let's say, summer. If we were to use an if-else statement to check the value of this season, and then depending on what that value is, it will see out a certain message. So if this season is summer, then I want you to see out the weather is very hot outside. End line. Otherwise, this season, otherwise, let's say, see out the weather can get hotter. End line. Okay, so if we were to compile and run this program, it should show the first result, which is this, which is the weather is very hot outside because the value stored is summer. And as you can see, the console window shows the weather is very hot outside. perfect, because as we see right here, we created our own season data type, which we define using the enum. And then we gave our variable a name called this season, initialized with the value of summer. And because as we've learned from our if else statement tutorial, that if this season is equal to summer, then it'll see out this value. Otherwise, if it's not summer, but rather spring, fall, winter, or whatever else, it'll see out the weather can get hotter. Perfect. Okay, so at this point, you're probably wondering, okay, besides using the seasons in a year, what else can you use enumerations for anyways? So let's say you wanted to create a user interactive program with different modes in them. One way is to use enumerations to list out the different modes of your program. And then you would have the user enter the name of a mode. And then depending on the mode that the user entered, you could use something like an if else else if statement, or perhaps a switch statement, which will determine, okay, if the case matches this mode inside the enum, then I want you to do this set of instructions inside the program. Otherwise, do something else. And with that in mind, that concludes our tutorial on enumerations in C++. Thank you for watching, and please like this video if you found it helpful. And if you have any questions, be sure to leave them in the comments below, and I'll take a look at them as soon as possible. And subscribe to stay tuned for more. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you next time.